Waking up and not having a cent to pay your bills is a bad place to be. It's even worse when you've had a lot of money in the past. Time and time again, America has had millionaires file for bankruptcy. Toni Braxton filed for bankruptcy twice, in 1998 and 2010, with debts from $10 million to $50 million. Before she first filed in 1998, she had sold 15 million albums. Curtis Jackson, popularly known as 50 Cent, also filed for bankruptcy in 2015 after earning millions from music and movies. Mike Tyson, who also earned a huge payday from boxing, filed for bankruptcy in 2003, claiming a debt of $23 million. Thankfully, Toni Braxton, Curtis Jackson, and Mike Tyson recovered, but many people don't. In this video, I'll talk about why people end up broke and what you can do to gain financial freedom. Number 1. Spending more than you earn. Let's cut to the chase. Spending more than you earn is a straightforward path to financial trouble. It's like trying to fill a bucket with a hole at the bottom. Unsustainable, and eventually, you'll find yourself in a financial mess. Your income is the lifeblood of your financial stability. You disrupt the balance between income and expenses when you consistently spend beyond your means. It's a basic equation. If the outflow consistently exceeds the inflow, you're heading toward financial instability. It can be worse during an emergency. An unpredictable life sometimes brings unexpected expenses. If you're already living above your means, you don't have the financial buffer necessary to absorb these shocks. You'll need to sacrifice all pleasure to live below your means. It boils down to spending your money wisely, defining your needs and wants, and making decisions that fit your financial objectives. Living below your means isn't rocket science, it's just simple math. Write down your income, remove some for savings and some for emergencies or any other important fund. The remainder is what you can spend. You'll never have to be in debt when you spend below your means. Number 2. Having no budget. Having no budget is like sailing through the unknown without a map. It puts you at undue risk and raises the odds of financial instability. I'll show you why not having a budget can accelerate your journey to bankruptcy. Your budget is your financial roadmap. Without it, you are almost driving with a blindfold. It allows you to plan your expenses according to your financial goals, whether saving for a home, paying off loans, or planning retirement. Having a budget is not just about planning your expenditures, but also about having the right distribution of resources. Without one, you'll likely waste your resources on unnecessary purchases, leaving little or nothing for significant expenditures, such as emergency savings and debt repayment. An emergency fund is an important part of your budget. Life is full of surprises, and a huge, unexpected bill can come at the most inconvenient time. Without a plan, it is less likely that you'll see the need to create any type of safety net at all. Not being prepared puts you in a debt spiral after unexpected events. Lack of budgeting will result in no financial discipline. Impulsive buying is one of the symptoms. Some people can't get a hold of themselves when they have money. They go on a spending spree without recourse to budget or concern for financial stability. Impulsive buying is one sure way to bankruptcy. Remember Mike Tyson, who filed for bankruptcy in 2003? One of the reasons he became broke was due to his spending addiction. He loved to pick up luxury items and did that recklessly until he ran out of cash. Suppose you want a stable and secure financial future. In that case, impulse buying is one habit you'll have to deal with. Rather, learn to budget and plan. Most of the time, some items bought impulsively are not necessarily needed, leaving a vacuum for more important stuff. How can you work around this? Simple, financial planning and budgeting. It will help you handle your expenses with prudence and strategy. If you've never made a budget, now's a good time to begin. To make it easier, you can find apps that help you make a budget. Although drawing a budget may require some strategic thinking, the hard part is sticking to it. That's where discipline becomes necessary. Number 3. Buying depreciating assets. Buying depreciating assets is a way to wear down your wealth over time. Unlike appreciating assets that tend to increase in value, Depreciating assets do the opposite. Firstly, let's define depreciating assets. Cars, electronic gadgets, and furniture lose value over time. When you drive a brand new car off the lot, it starts losing value, and this depreciation continues every year. The challenge with these assets is that they don't contribute to your net worth. Instead, they represent a constant drain on your financial resources. Take a car, for example. Although it's necessary for most, it's one of the fastest depreciating assets. A new car may come off sleek and shiny when you buy it. Still, it will lose its worth considerably during the first few years, leaving you with a depreciated asset that continues to lose value. Advances in technology even make this worse. Consider the latest smartphone on the shelf. It is modern but will soon become obsolete. So suppose you're constantly hunting for the latest gadgets. In that case, you're enslaving yourself into a perpetual cycle of depreciation where investments in technology become old news far too rapidly. Assets such as real estate quickly appreciate, improving your net worth with time. On the other hand, investing constantly in depreciating assets can only result in losses. Investing in appreciating assets over time can reduce the negative consequences of depreciating assets for your financial well-being. This can offset the decline associated with depreciation and promote long-term sustainability. Number 4. Lacking a savings culture. Having a savings culture is beyond just putting money in a piggy bank. It is an integral pillar of financial discipline. Secondly, savings are your financial security. Since life is uncertain, unexpected expenses can come at any time, from medical emergencies, auto repairs, or job loss. Without a savings cushion, you may need to depend on credit cards or loans, leading to more debt. Think about the peace that comes with an emergency fund. It is not just about having a pool of funds, but the ability to endure financial turmoil while maintaining overall financial health. A savings mentality promotes financial prudence. It helps you consistently save some of your earnings, no matter how much or little. Now, about retirement, you may only enjoy your retirement with a savings culture. And while Social Security may offer a reprieve, it's a gamble to depend solely on it. By saving regularly, you're contributing toward your future financial security. Savings can grow over time, and compound interest makes your saved money bigger. A lack of a savings culture deprives you of this opportunity to build wealth. Instead of earning dividends, a lack of a savings culture limits your ability to meet your financial goals. Number 5. Having too much debt. Here's a shocking fact. At least 35% of Americans say they're in the most debt. This trend shows how huge a problem debt is in many American homes. This presents a challenge because getting out of debt is more challenging than getting into it. Think of your financial situation as a balancing act. Debt feels weights on one side. Initially, it may appear insignificant, a credit card purchase here and that loan there. As debts increase, it's almost like adding more weight. Interest is the ever-hungry thief of your income when you are indebted. It may seem like a small hiccup, but in the long run, it can suck out a great deal of your savings. There's also the psychological aspect. Debt is a nagging stressor that follows you like a constant shadow, hiding in the recesses of your mind. You have to deal with payments and deadlines every month. Trying to carry the load can be more than you can bear. It's like walking with a backpack full of rocks, tolerable for some time, but eventually wears you out. Accumulating debt reduces your financial freedom. It's like being in a financial labyrinth with very few opportunities. You may want to invest in that business, but your debt has other things in mind. Are you dreaming of buying a home? Debt might shut the door of that dream. And don't forget about emergencies, life surprises. However, even a little crisis can become a financial tsunami when drowning in debt. So what do you do if you're neck deep in debt? With planning and discipline, you can claw your way out. Start by estimating your total debt, then reach out to your creditors and negotiate a repayment plan. See how much you can take from your income to service your debt. If you need to simplify things, consult a professional financial advisor. They can offer expert advice and guide you through the process. Number 6. Lacking financial literacy. Remember the popular saying, knowledge is power. While it may be an overused statement, it remains an eternal truth. How can you make the right money decisions when you don't know how it works? Financial literacy should be the starting point. You can make the right decisions and spot the wrong advice or strategies with the right knowledge. You should also know about investments, interests, budgeting, credit cards, and inflation. Reports indicate that only 57% of Americans are financially literate. While it's worrisome, you can understand why many people make the wrong financial choices. Understanding budgeting is a huge step toward financial stability. You'll learn to separate your wants from your needs and prioritize expenses. Knowing how investment works is another crucial part of financial literacy. Investing can be confusing if you don't know how it works, and you may even be disinterested, missing out on opportunities for your money to grow. Or worse, you might venture mindlessly, risking your hard-earned cash on unfamiliar terrain. Moreover, lacking financial literacy can make you susceptible to financial scams. It's akin to navigating a minefield without a map. Fraudulent schemes can be disguised as financial opportunities. You might find your pockets empty by deceit without the knowledge to discern. Number 7. Wanting to get rich quickly. Some people are broke because they're in a hurry to become rich. They need more patience, and in their desire to become rich as quickly as possible, have either fallen into scams or have made unreasonably risky investments. While some people have been lucky to hit the jackpot, wealth building is a process. It doesn't happen overnight. Those who stumble on overnight riches may easily lose it if they make poor financial choices. One of the pitfalls of wanting quick wealth is the tendency to fall for get-rich-quick schemes. It's like being handed a treasure map that promises gold at a certain point, only to find out it leads to a dead end. Pyramid schemes, cryptocurrency gambles, and the like often become more of a financial quicksand than a shortcut to wealth. People who want to get rich fast will likely be blinded by the risks involved. It's like driving with your eyes closed, hoping you don't run over a pothole. Generally, investments promising astronomical gains come with corresponding risks. You can earn as much as you might lose. For instance, look at the stock market. It is an enticing playground for fast wins, but it doesn't always work that way. Unfortunately, some people turn it into a gambling ground, ignoring the rules. Eventually, many of them end up with empty pockets. There's also the category of people who start a business to make profits quickly. Although this may have worked for a few people, overnight business success is still far-fetched. Building a successful business takes time, effort, and a good dose of resilience. Number 8. Gambling. Gambling hasn't only messed people up, it has also destroyed homes. And if you want to enjoy financial stability, you should stay away from gambling. Sometimes, people consider investment as gambling, often in a bid to justify their involvement. So here's the scoop. In regular investing, you want a good chance of making more money than you put in. With gambling, it's the opposite. The odds are rigged so that over time, you're likely to end up with less money. The house, aka the casino, always has the upper hand. This whole math thing is done to ensure they come out on top. To ensure continued patronage, casinos play mind games on their customers. The excitement of the game can mess with your head. Emotions take over, and you make impulsive bets instead of smart money moves. Again, there's also the danger of becoming addicted. Gambling can quickly turn from harmless fun into a wallet-draining habit. It's like a slippery slope. You lose, you want to win it back, and before you know it, you're in a financial free fall. Financial experts stress the importance of staying disciplined, setting limits, and not letting the thrill of the game cloud your judgment. In finance, you want your money to work for you, not against you. Gambling is far from the thoughtful, strategic approach experts recommend for building and protecting wealth. Number 9. Having only one income stream. For many people, having one income stream used to be okay. You'd have enough money to pay your bills and even keep something on the side for a rainy day or emergencies. But that's no longer enough. If you have only one source of income, Chances are you'll quickly run out of money and need to use credit to fund your daily living before your next payday. The reason is the rising cost of living. Housing, healthcare, and education expenses in the US are currently among the highest in the world, so you'll need more than one income stream. Apart from investing, you could take freelance jobs like writing, editing, and virtual assistants. You could also learn more skills, especially those in high demand, to expose you to more opportunities. You could also start a business. Whatever you choose, having another source of income will help you meet your bills while having something extra to play with. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Which points resonate with your personal experience? How did you deal with it? Share your experience in the comment box below. Remember to like and share this video. If you want a steady stream of financial advice, subscribe to my channel.